of Business Today, where we would be honoring those companies who have achieved best companies to work for. There was a time when the best organization to work for was government, and everybody's dream was to work for government. Nowadays, people have become more aspiring. Youth in the country has become more talented, and the private sector has opened up new horizons to catch their aspirations. So on one hand, the best companies are trying to retain their talents, and our government is so full of talents that we want to retrench few. But you must agree that the best of the people given to the private sector are from government, because the exposure what you get in the government is immense, and you work at absolute grassroots and in any condition, and that gives you such knowledge of grassroots that people mostly, if you look back 10-15 years, all the consultancy services in the country were started, flooded and flourished from the people who opted out of government and joined the private companies. But I feel that as we all say, we are living in exciting times, and the companies, and especially the HR heads, have a tough task. On one hand, they have to maintain the team spirit, they have to nurture the best talents, they have to complement who are not so best, and I think diversity does not mean only geographies or gender, it also means capabilities, and different capabilities put together makes a company better. So every single employee has something special to offer, and that speciality of an employee needs to be nurtured. I'm very happy that since last few decades, the companies have been focusing more on providing good working environment to their employees. It adds to their efficiency. If we don't look at their living standards, their families, it ultimately affects the work of company. And I think the judges must have judged companies on based of certain parameters, but I feel it's not just those companies who are doing well and have money to spend on many activities for the benefit of their employees, but we should also judge those companies who have entered the competitive world may not be doing so well, but still are doing lot of things for their employees to upgrade them, to look at their families, to look at their health. And I think the values in those companies are really valuable, because ultimately all these things are part of values. And when the company has core values which encourages the employees to do the best, I think it also encourages them to be truthful and to do the work ethically. And I think in today's competitive world, although competition matters, but ethics matter most. And the companies which tries to inculcate these ethical values into their employees, I think they should be judged as the best companies. The times in India now is changing. The investment climate is changing. And while the global economy is again fearing a recession, we are still developing at a good rate. And as rightly said by our Honorable Prime Minister, the demography, democracy and demand in this country has opened up new avenues of investment in the recent Make in India week. We could see absolute awareness amongst the global community towards strength of India and their interests to invest into India. I think that this is the right time when we can leapfrog. And when we look at our demography, it's not a thing which would continue to be leveraged for a long time. Now we are the most youthful country, and we will remain to be so by 2035. And the demographic advantage can be leveraged up to 2050. Beyond that, and from 2035, this demographic advantage would transfer to the African countries. So I feel that we have a very limited time, and in this time, the business usual would not make us the leaders of the world. It's a leapfrog attempt that would change the lives of people in our country, and that would make us a global leader. I feel the companies like you have not only opportunity but also responsibility not to lose this opportunity, so that you contribute into this dream of making India a developed nation, a economically very strong nation, a nation which can lead the entire world. And to achieve this, I think best practices is the way forward. And this award, which is actually for the companies which are supposed to be best to work for, are practicing all these best things, the best practices, and I'm sure you would continue to do so. after my speech, the awards would be announced, so there is still a suspense. I do not know who is getting award. But all the companies present here, those who will be getting awards, I would like to congratulate them, but also those who could compete, because it must have been a tough job for the judges to actually single out the best. So, to all the companies who have participated, I would like to congratulate them, and I'm sure with this attitude of adopting the best practices, we will enrich the business environment of our country. I would also like to congratulate Business Today for this initiative and also for giving me this opportunity to interact with you all. Thank you. Thank you very much.